I cannot wait for this. This just seems so cute. Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Averie, and today I'm going to be showing y'all my TBR for the romance-a-thon. Okay, I have a lot of books to talk about today. If you did not know what the romance-a-thon is about, it is a week-long readathon about romance books. You read romance books and you're trying to fulfill all 7 prompts. There are 2 hosts, I believe. I cannot recall their names at the moment, but I will for sure link them down below, so please be sure to go check out their wonderful channels. So I'm gonna get started and talk about all these books really quick. Okay, so the buddy read for the romance-a-thon is On the Island by Tracy Garbus Graves. I am going to be reading this on my phone, my ebook on the Kindle app. This is going to complete the challenge for a forbidden romance. Okay, so for most of these books, I'm going to be reading the summary for y'all because I personally don't know all that much about them and rather share the summary with y'all instead of just listing them off and not giving a summary, so I'm just gonna read it for y'all. When 30-year-old English teacher Anna Emerson is offered a job tutoring at TJ Callahan at his family's summer rental in the Maldives, she accepts without hesitation. A working vacation on a tropical island trumps the library any day. TJ Callahan has no desire to leave town. Not that anyone asked him. He's almost 17, and if having cancer wasn't bad enough, now he has to spend his first summer in remission with his family and a stack of overdue assignments instead of his friends. Anna and TJ are en route to join TJ's family in the Maldives when the pilot of their seaplane suffers a fatal heart attack and crash lands in the Indian Ocean. Adrift in shark-infested waters, their life jackets keep them afloat until they make it to the shore of an uninhabited island. Now Anna and TJ just want to survive, and they must work together to obtain water, food, fire, and shelter. Their basic needs might be met, but as the days turn to weeks and then months, the castaways encounter plenty of other obstacles, including violent tropical storms and many dangers lurking in the seas, and the possibility that TJ's cancer could return. As TJ celebrates yet another birthday on the island, Anna begins to wonder if the biggest challenge of all might be living with a boy who is gradually becoming a man. This is obviously a age gap romance, so it's kind of basically forbidden. It's kind of like a student-teacher relationship. She is his 30-year-old tutor, so. I never heard about this book before I found out it was the buddy read, so it wasn't really on my radar, but now it is, so I can't wait to read it. Next, we have Jake's Redemption by Jamie Schultz. This was kindly sent to me by the publisher, so thank y'all so much. Again, I cannot wait to get into this in the month of June. This is going to be completing the challenge for Read a Romance Book released in 2019. This was released earlier in the year. So this book actually has men enslaved. I'm not sure if it's alien enslavement or maybe futuristic Earth. I'm not sure about that yet, but basically in this book, by the back, I could tell that the men are enslaved. One of the men, Jake, ends up falling in love for his captor or the guard to his cell. So it is a big forbidden romance for sure. It was so wonderful that this publisher sent this book to me. So I want to thank y'all so much, and I cannot wait to dive into it because I'm really, really, really excited. Next, we have Style by Chelsea M. Cameron. This is going to be another ebook that I read, and this is going to be completing the challenge for reading an LGBTQ+ romance. Kyle Blake likes plans. So far, they're pretty simple. Finish her senior year of high school, head off to a good college, find a cute boyfriend, graduate, get a job, get married, the whole heterosexual shebang. Nothing is going to stand in the way of that plan. Not even Stella Lewis. Stella Lewis also has a plan. Finish her senior year as cheer captain, go to college, finally let herself flirt with, and maybe even date a girl for the first time, and go from there. Fate has other plans for Kyle and Stella when they're paired up in their AP English class and something between them ignites. It's confusing and overwhelming, and neither of them know what to do about it. One thing they do know is that their connection can't be ignored. The timing just isn't right. But is there ever a good time for falling in love? This sounds so, 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 so cute. I think I heard about this book from Riley Marie. I cannot wait for this. This just seems so cute. The next book we have is Trust in Me by Jay Lynn or Jennifer L. Armentrout. This is going to be another ebook that I read because I do not have the physical book, and this is going to be completing the challenge of the new adult romance category. So my favorite book of the year so far is Wait for You by Jennifer L. Armentrout. Trust in Me is Wait for You all in the perspective of the guy Cam, because Wait For You is actually told only in the point of view of our main character named Averie. So this is all about Cam's point of view, and I'm super duper excited. This is a romance book set in college, all about a girl named Averie who is trying to escape her past and have a new fresh start in a college town all the way across the country from where her hometown is. She meets a guy named Cam who is a soccer superstar for the campus that she now lives on, and sparks fly between them, but it's way more than a romance. Averie deals with a lot of past trauma. There's a bunch of trigger warnings. If you want to know the trigger warnings, please DM me or something and I will let you know. It's just way more than a romance. It's about a girl finding herself again, which I love, and I'm really excited to figure out what all of Cam's thoughts were while in this book. Next we have The Protector by Jodi Ellen Malpass, and this is going to be completely challenged for read a book with a man on the cover. This is going to be my audiobook. By the looks of it, it's going to be coming in around the time of the romance-a-thon. I have it on hold right now. People think that they have Camille Logan nailed. Daddy's girl, beautiful, spoiled young woman with a father's bank balance to fund her lifestyle. But Camille is determined to have a life free from his strings. Out of her town, she's made mistakes, including one that found her clawing her way back after a stint in rehab and plenty of bad press. Now, after fighting so hard to be an independent and happy, she finds her life threatened as a result of her father's ruthless business dealings. Caught between resentment and fear, Camille prepares herself for the measures her father will take to protect her. But nothing could prepare her for the ex-SAS sniper who crashes into her life. Jake Sharp resides in his own personal hell. He was distracted from duty once before, and the consequences were devastating, both personally and professionally. He vowed never to let that happen again. Accepting the job of bodyguard to Camille Logan isn't the kind of distraction from his demons that he should take. Women and Jake don't mix well, yet protecting the heiress seems to be the lesser of two evils. But Jake soon discovers that she isn't the woman she's perceived to be. She's warm, compassionate, her presence settling, and his duty to protect her soon goes deeper than a well-paid job. No matter how hard he fights it, he needs absolution. He comes to need Camille, but he knows he cannot have both. This sounds so good, and I needed an audiobook, and this one was right there for me to click on, so I decided to pick it up. It looks really good and really cool, so I cannot wait to get into this one as well. And lastly on this list, we have Debbie's Distraction by Ruby Dixon. I will also be reading this as an ebook. This is going to be completely challenged for a read a book with pink on the cover. This is the final book that I have to read to complete the Ice Planet Barbarians / Ice Home series by Ruby Dixon. Basically, they're alien romance books that I absolutely love. Reading this book is going to have me up to date for all of the Ruby Dixon books for the Ice Planet and Ice Home series. I'm so excited to actually complete this series. If you didn't know what Ice Home or Ice Planet Barbarians are about, basically this is a sci-fi romance book all about Earth women who end up getting captured by evil aliens. These women end up crash landing in the spaceship they're abducted in onto this big ice planet. The evil aliens die, and the human women are rescued by these men from the planet, and they are blue-skinned people with horns and tails and blue eyes. They have this parasite in them called a kui, which will indicate to them when their lifelong mate and partner is near. So it's about a bunch of human women being paired up with and finding their lifelong mate with a blue alien. They're just books that I love to read. I know they're not the most well-written books, but I have so much fun reading them, so I'm excited I'm going to be completing all of the books that are out right now. So there you have it. That is my TBR for the romance-a-thon. I cannot wait for this. I'm super duper duper excited. Be sure to let me know down below if you are participating and if you have posted a TBR video for the romance-a-thon. I'd love to know, so link it down below. Also let me know what your favorite romance book is, because I need to add more to my TBR shelf. Anyways, thank y'all so much for watching, and I will see y'all soon with a new video. Bye!